Some features I prefer about the Nokia 7.2 over the Nokia 7 Plus. Having used the Nokia 7 Plus for 2 years, I decided the Nokia 7.2, which was announced and released in September 2019, was a worthy upgrade. Why I find the 7.2 perfect? I love the clean interface and the minimalist Android One. It is what version of Android I can handle. Also, I'm comfortable with the Nokia brand, having used it more than any other in the last 16 years. Now to the 7 features I prefer on the Nokia 7.2. Bigger screen. I've been used to bigger screens since back when I used the iPhone 6 Plus. The Nokia 7.2 offers a bigger screen while being only slightly bigger in the hand than the 7 Plus. The manufacturer HMD Global was able to achieve this partly due to the smaller bezels the 7.2 has. Faster, smoother experience. The 7.2 offers an overall faster and smoother experience. This is despite the fact that it uses the same Qualcomm Snapdragon 660 chipset. Granted, my 7.2 has a 6GB RAM, while the 7 Plus has a 4GB RAM. But the higher gig RAM would definitely improve the experience when using it. Dedicated SD card slot. My minimum requirement for a smartphone based on my need is it must have a dual SIM and have a dedicated micro SD card slot. I take a bit of photos, videos, and have 5 active SIMs from 4 different countries. The 7.2 has a dedicated micro SD slot, while the 7 Plus only offers a shared slot for SD cards. Better screen. After using the 7.2 for about 5 weeks now, it's a bit harder to use the 7 Plus occasionally. The screen on the 7.2 is brighter and better in every way. The 7.2 supports the HDR10 technology, which makes one's video playing experience better. Camera system. The camera system on the 7.2 is just better. Not only does the biggest camera peak at 48 megapixels, but it also offers an extra wide lens, which I haven't put too much use with outdoor photography due to the extensive lockdown in South Africa at this time. All the same, the 7.2 offers more lenses and sharper images. I love that the camera software on the 7.2 comes with a pause button. This makes video recordings much more creative. I have had to make use of a third-party app known as Open Camera on the 7 Plus for this feature alone, thus losing image stabilization on that phone when using that app. FM radio. Yes, I hardly have to use this FM radio daily, considering I can make use of the tune-in radio for a better radio experience. But it's good to know that the FM radio is there for when one is out of internet coverage and needs to listen to radio. The Nokia 7.2 has this, while the 7 Plus does not. Aesthetics. While the 7 Plus was good looking in its own way, the 7.2 is much more visually pleasing with its premium design. The shape of the teardrop notch, the arrangement of the camera system on the back, the fingerprint placements, all make this an object of beauty. Bonus feature. The 7.2 has a very functional face unlock that is convenient to use, especially during the day. The face unlock on the 7 Plus was disabled when I upgraded it to Android 10. Conclusion. Overall, while it is not perfect, I find the Nokia 7.2 to be a worthy upgrade in every way. If you enjoyed this video, please click on the like button and remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching, and bye for now.